In a previous lesson, we discussed the events that are automatically collected by Google Analytics. These are events like first visit or first open to register the first time a user visits a website or app. However, there will be times when there are events that you will want to collect that are specific to your business. Let's take a look at the Google Merchandise Store and some events that you'd want to create if this were your website. If you manage an e-commerce site, you'll want to know what purchases users make. Additionally, you may also want to know when users add or remove items from their shopping cart or select a promotion when they check out. Each action requires creating and collecting a new e-commerce event. Once created, you can use these event parameters to create custom dimensions and metrics in your reports. These e-commerce events are part of the recommended events list available in the Google Analytics Help Center. Specifically for e-commerce, you'll want to pay close attention to these events when implementing and be sure to follow the implementation guidance so that you properly collect your e-commerce information. If you need to collect events not included in recommended events, you can set up custom events and parameters specific to your business needs. We recommend following a similar naming convention and suggest reusing event names and parameter names where possible to streamline your data collection and reporting efforts. The values of these parameters collected will distinguish this data and allow you to analyze it in detail. In the admin menu, you can view and manage events being collected. Here you can see we've already created some common e-commerce events like purchases, adding items to the shopping cart, and removing items from the shopping cart. Keep in mind that when you add recommended events, you will start sending this event data to Google Analytics, but you need to register custom dimensions and metrics that correspond to the event parameters to see them in your reports. This can be done in the admin section. Creating a custom dimension can be done in just a few easy steps. First, you'll provide the name of the custom dimension or metric that you want to create. It's a good practice to use the same name as the parameter that you're registering. When creating a custom dimension, you'll also need to define the scope of that dimension. You have three options: event, user, or item scope dimensions. The scope determines how custom dimensions are applied to your data. An event scope dimension provides information about an action that a user performs. For example, the title of an article that someone viewed would be an event scope dimension. A user scope dimension provides information about the user who performed the action. For example, the geographic location of the person who viewed an article would be a user scope dimension. An item scope dimension provides information about the products or services that users interact with in an event. For example, when someone makes a purchase on the merchandise store, we might want to know what the color of the item was that was sold. You can also choose to give the custom dimension a description. The final step is choosing the parameter you want to register from the drop-down menu. All parameters that you're sending to Google Analytics but have not yet registered as custom dimensions will show up in this list. Creating a custom metric follows the same process, but a custom metric always has an event scope, so no need to define the scope for these.